easy. Thanks to loyal listener Big Deals, I found new places to eat, have fun, take the family out, and get my car fixed. With loyal listener Big Deals, you can save money and try new businesses. Go to WPKYonline.com. But you better hurry. You never know how long each deal will last.
Your home team at Trice Hughes wants to make sure your vehicle lasts as long as possible, especially since warmer weather means more driving. Trice Hughes reminds you that tire pressure is critical to maximizing the performance of your vehicle. From improved fuel mileage to smoother tire wear, make sure your tires are inflated to the correct PSI.
Trice Hughes is here for you and any questions you may have about your vehicle. Buy your next vehicle from the home team. Find them on Highway 91 North, Princeton, or at TriceHughes.com.
1580, 103.3 WPKY. Mr. Presley, Brother Presley Lamb, how are you?
Outstanding. How are you?
I saw you in your neck of the woods the other day.
That's right.
Coon I had dog to stop in. By and get me a little coon dog. When you're on your way to just about anywhere, or if you're just there because you want to, that's a good place to get a cheeseburger right. into lunchtime. Yeah, it looked like y'all were meeting.
Golf.
Well, I was on my way to play golf, and yeah. I needed that cheeseburger.
And you didn't even offer me to go.
Well,
so I appreciate that.
I was a little embarrassed. I mean, you should. You don't want to golf with people you know.
Yeah.
Because later on, they can use that against you. See,
yeah,
that's
leverage why. Later on. I have that happen to me a lot, too.
I end up in the woods a lot. Me and Jesus, we talk a lot when I golf. I don't know about you.
That's good. Yeah.
Lord help me find the ball. That's what
I find people on different fairways and everything else. I had all kinds of conversations.
I'll tell you what, though. It was so nice because when I come in and saw you, I saw everybody. Everybody, it was kind of like the meeting of the minds that day. I loved it. That's when you know that something good's going on somewhere.
That's right.
When you
Absolutely.
See that's where the local folk go, that's what you want.
Yeah.
So what's going on at Fredonia First Baptist Church?
Well, we have... there's always something, but this specifically, it's still in the works, but it's finalized, but we're still working out some of the details. But October 31st, we know we're having a Treats on the Street.
Oh, that sounds good.
And we're going to completely lock down Doro Street in Fredonia and have the kids. So we do abide by the rules, the
right.
social distancing. We're going to urge everybody to show up at one of the yards. Ask the people first. Don't just show up in somebody's yard. But I live on Doral Street, so you can just show up in my yard. But the rest of them you need to ask. And just make some kind of contraption that's 6 feet long. It'd be a clothesline, you know, a PVC pipe, slingshot, fishing pole. So you can kind of sling it to them. Catapult. Just don't sling it at the kids, but, you know, we don't know about
Now you're taking the fun out of it.
Well, if you do, make sure it's soft candy.
Well, there we go.
And give them a heads up. You know, you want to give them a heads up. But anyway, it's going to be a – that way the kids can walk down the street, still get the candy and still get the experience, and we can still be safe. You can park in the church parking lot, and we'll be shuttling people over.
Well, and you know what? I admire that you guys get out and make sure that the kids can enjoy it one way or the other. You did that during Easter this past year, and I thought that was the neatest thing, where you went out and, you know, helped people maybe throw some eggs around in the yard.
Absolutely.
And, Fredonia has a way of doing that and making sure that the kids, you know, still get to enjoy stuff.
Absolutely. I think we're underestimating the impact this is having on our kids, and sometimes they just need something to get together, even though they may be 6 feet apart, they can still get together and have fun and make sure the community knows that we still love them. We hadn't forgot about them. We're not, you know.
Well, it gives them something to look forward to,
absolutely.
Too.
Absolutely. So they can look forward. October 31st is going to be a big time. And the adults are going to have a big time.
Oh,
you know, it's
going to
be fun.
It.
I'm already thinking about contraptions that I can make.
I have no doubt. I cannot wait to see what Mayor Seibert comes up with, because he's the contraption man.
He'd be right up his alley.
He's like the mad scientist. I cannot wait to see what he comes up with. I really can't.
It makes me a little nervous, but you know.
Well, you know.
Anything that Jimmy's involved in kind of makes you a little nervous.
So, I expect to see a lot of unicorns, but I just expect to see a lot of smiles is what I expect
absolutely.
To see. So you've got maybe some things going on, looking forward to the holidays as well at church.
Yeah, we have, you know, the normal things, which are still great things. You know, the kids just started their practice for their big Christmas program. And
I think that's going to be a cool one, too, by the way.
Yeah, absolutely. I think so, too. We got some great adults that are helping with that.
That black light glove performance, I think, is going to be cool. And any time that you can do something like that, that's unique. I think it puts a new spin on it.
I think you attract their minds and their attention to something good. And sometimes, you know, although our message doesn't change, the methods that we use certainly should. And that's just another way that we can zero their thinking in on the gospel in a fun way, especially at that age. That's a good thing. And I think Eric Horner will be there with his Christmas show in December, too. I can't remember the dates, but we'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Yeah. Well, and my grandma used to say, idle hands and idle minds are the devil's playground. And I think that you keep them busy, and I think that's a good thing.
Yeah, and I think sometimes we instead of idle hands, it should be lazy hands, you know.
Well,
sometimes we just don't
ain't that another show right there, isn't it?
Yeah, not to get distracted, but, you know.
Well, that'd take all day, brother.
Yeah, yeah. I hope you don't get no phone calls.
Okay. Well, you know what, though? When you're talking about family stuff and kids stuff, I don't think you can go wrong with that.
Absolutely not.
And as long as, you know, they're being, you know, we do ask that you be respectful.
Sure.
And, you know
it's just, you know, be mature about it. You know, you know what message we're trying to portray. And the message we're trying to teach, we don't want to do anything contrary to that.
You know, well, and you don't have to be from Fredonia to come either,
absolutely
right?
Absolutely not. You know, come just, and again, it's easy to find. A lot of people may not know where Doral Street is specifically. But if you'll park in the First Baptist Church, and we're partnering with this, by the way, with the CP Church across the street. And they have a new pastor named Mark Bell, Brother Mark Bell. I met with him, and we're collaborating on this and a lot of their folks. So this is not just a First Baptist thing. This is a Fredonia event in us and the Presbyterian Church across the street.
Well, you know, there's a good lesson in that, too, though.
Absolutely.
And working together, Cumberland Presbyterian and First Baptist across the street from each other in Fredonia. There's something to be said for neighbors working together.
And there's going to be a gift basket for every child, and then that's not even, you know, including the candy that you're going to get, you know, in at the ballpark. That's the best way to remember it. The Doro ends there at the ballpark, and we'll have there'll be all kinds of fun stuff.
I promise you, if you get to Fredonia, you'll find it.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. That's what I always tell. But if you can find Fredonia,
which that's easy these days. I mean, you know,
one road. Get on one road, drive toward in the direction that the sign tells you until you get there, and then once you get there, you can't miss it.
And it's a beautiful drive right now too,
absolutely,
because it's with the colors changing, it's a nice weather.
Man, what a day! Yesterday was more like late summer.
It was, wasn't it? So very nice. Tell us your hours and everything over at First Baptist.
First Baptist, we're having two services, 9 a.m. and 10:50 a.m.
Okay.
And we'd love to have you have some Sunday school between the services around 10 o'clock. And, of course, Wednesday night at 6 p.m. We actually moved that back. We used to meet at 7, but we're meeting at 6 p.m. now. It really had nothing to do with COVID. It's one of the few things that didn't have anything to do with COVID. We just decided that 6 p.m. was more effective for all of our folks. And really,
I think a lot of Baptist churches do that during the fall because of the time change.
Yeah, it's just easier getting kids into bed and back to school and all that good stuff. So it was just better for our folks. And our kids' programs are starting to pick back up, and our adults, there's people starting to come back, and we're doing everything we can to be safe. We're disinfecting everything and still distancing. So we still got the pews marked off.
Well, I know Wednesday at 6 is when the practice for your Christmas program
is. Yeah.
So if they want their kids to be involved in that, Wednesday nights at 6.
Yeah, and we're usually split up. You know, we got the little kids, and we got the junior high kids, and we got the high school kids, and then the adults meet in the sanctuary. So just something for everybody on Wednesday night.
Well, and I think that's going to be a good thing, too. It kind of feels normal. And anytime you can make it feel, well, whatever normal is anymore. But
I'm not sure we have
that feeling that, you know, you've done it before. Whatever that's called, whether that's
familiarity,
normal.
Familiarity, at least.
Yeah. Familiar, that's a really good word. Whatever that is, that's what we want to feel. Absolutely. So October 31st, and that starts at?
4 p.m., I believe.
4 o'clock. That sounds good.
4 o'clock.
Bring out the unicorns and fairy dust. We're ready to go and get your creativity going because you've got...
bring a contraption.
A contraption.
Even if you don't live on Dora Street, just make something and put it in somebody's yard. Ask them first. I don't want, or put it in my yard. You don't have to ask me.
Just put it in Brother Presley.
Just put it in my yard.
You're going to so regret this later.
Yeah, I can't the first
see
time.
Jim Seifert in your yard before you get home.
Yeah, with this new super secret project.
I'm telling you, he's got it worked up.
That always
up.
Worries me when he says super secret project.
It's super, super secret, and I've asked him like 25 times, and he won't tell me what it is.
Yeah.
I got it. I've got ideas in my head, but he does too, and that's what surprises me. So there is something going
Nothing
on.
Nothing surprises me.
Something's going on in Fredonia, but it's top secret and nobody can know about it. I'm going to figure it out.
So evidently, he's not finished.
Yet is the key sentence there.
Yes, awesome.
Now, on Wednesday nights at 6, you've got the Christmas program, and the kids of all ages can show up about 6 o'clock.
6 o'clock.
And get involved in that.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you for coming in.
Thanks for having me. Sorry I was late.
We appreciate you. Oh, late. We're
Shout
fine.
Out to the employees at Broadbent Country Hams in Catawba.
Yes.
I went over my time this morning. So.
We're fine. Hey, Broadbent, they can say hi any day. Yeah. Are you kidding me? Well, thank you.
They pay me in bacon, so that's good.
I guarantee you, I would love. If they could talk to Beth, I'm open. Thanks so much. We appreciate you, Brother Lamb.
Thanks, Tess.
Again, check them out on social media, or they've got their website and social media all up there, and you can get all those updates right there. First Baptist Church in Fredonia. Hang out with us. Oh, I've got a woman with a hot cup of coffee. Hang out.
Your local McDonald's wants you to know that they're ready to serve you for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. They've always had their drive-thru, and now they're offering curbside pickup service as well. To avoid the wait in the drive-thru, you can download the McDonald's app and try curbside pickup. They appreciate your patience and understanding during this time. We are all having to adjust to this new way of life. It's temporary, but in the meantime, enjoy breakfast, lunch, or dinner at your local McDonald's.
The Joint is serving up pulled pork, brisket, jumbo wings, ribs, chicken, and more, with all the fixings to go with it from their secret family recipes, all at The Joint in Eddyville.
Tomorrow night, yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Coach Stoops and the Cats are under the lights in Lexington for our primetime battle.
Look out.
Mississippi State Bulldogs and your Kentucky Wildcats.
UK and Mississippi State. Airtime is 4:30 tomorrow afternoon.
On 106.5 WKDZ.
1580, 103.3 WPKY. I love it when this woman hits the door. I don't ever get to see her enough. That's the problem. But it's Miss Cathy Lewis. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. I even gave your husband a plug this morning. He'd be proud of me. Normally, I forget poor Lecrae.
I know. I begged him to come in today, but he had a last-minute job he's got to get ready for this afternoon. So he was like, there's no way I can make it over.
Well, we still love you, Cray. But this morning, I said, you know what? Cray said, wait a minute. You ain't going to outdo me, lady. Taco John's is getting in on this, too. So we were talking about it earlier, and this is one thing that I want to make sure that we hit, is Dinner for King.
Absolutely.
And I thought this was so cool. And it's not... I don't know why I'm surprised, but it's not like a 10% donation. No. You're going all out with a 25% of all your proceeds from 5 to 10 p.m. on your big fall menu.
Correct.
So that's crazy.
Yeah. So Gather on Main, downtown Princeton. Of course, we're the new restaurant in downtown Princeton. But next Saturday night, Saturday the 17th, I know everybody in this area, or a lot of people in this area, know Elizabeth King. If you don't, you're missing out. She was, of course, we know her. Our kids are all the same age. But she also was one of Harper's teachers. And Harper is my child that kind of struggles at school. And Miss King was always there to make sure Harper made it through. I think she had more confidence in that child than anybody, and that pushed her so far.
She's just a sweetheart. I think everybody's got, almost like you said, everybody loves her. If you meet her, you love her.
And she just, it's a good family. They're good people. And she's, of course, battling breast cancer right now and having kind of a hard time. And she's still smiling. It's amazing how these people, and she's not the only one. There's a lot in our area like this, but they just keep smiling and keep trucking along. And she's got kids the same age as my kids. They're in school together, and she's still just doing what she's got to do to get through everything right now that she's going through. So,
well, when you talk to her, you wouldn't know because she's not going to say, "Oh, woe is me." She's let me talk about the kids, or let's talk about what the kids are doing. She doesn't, you know, she doesn't turn that around on herself.
No, absolutely
not.
And
ask for anything. So,
we had decided that Cray and I decided we wanted to do something to kind of help their family out and give back a little bit to Miss Elizabeth and her family. So, next Saturday night, the 17th of October, our dinner menu, which we run dinner from 5 to 10 o'clock at night. We launch next Saturday night, actually Friday night, but we launch next week our new fall menu. And we decided that would be a fantastic time to say, come out, try the new menu, get some dinner, enjoy yourselves, and 25% of the proceeds go to Miss Elizabeth King.
That fall menu, for Pete's sake.
Yeah, it's going to be awesome.
I mean, please. Is that on it?
It is.
That's what I thought. Tell everybody what I'm pointing at.
That's our new pork roast that'll be on the fall menu. And I say that, and everybody goes, oh, okay, roast, but you have no idea. Josh hit it out of the park with this one.
Is that cheese?
No, it's got and Josh would have to give you exact details. I've got the menu. I haven't totally memorized it yet, but it's got a fabulous sauce on it it's got potatoes under it. You've absolutely got to try Josh's food to understand the complex flavors.
You gotta go on their social media and see that. I mean, that's fantastic.
The fall menu is going to be great. We're launching a few new items that you don't see a lot in this area. We have a gnocchi coming to our fall menu, and if you haven't had a potato gnocchi, it's a fabulous way to do a quote-unquote pasta. It's kind of not a pasta since it's a potato dumpling,
but it's
fabulous.
It's so good, though. It's one of those, you want a comfort food?
Right.
That is comfort inside comfort with comfort over the top of it. I mean, it's comfort.
Right. Our fall menu will do the same thing that our spring and summer menu did. We'll feature a lot of, obviously, Broadbent's, Newsom's, a lot of local items. We'll feature all of the in-season, and that's why we change menus, in-season vegetables and fruits. And, you know, we loved our BLT all summer long, but tomatoes are done. And we're not going to serve them when they're not at peak ripeness. So it's time for us to switch menus out and go to the vegetables and fruits that are in season.
That's what I respect about you guys, though. You don't just say, well, now we'll just go get them from, you know, we'll go across the big ocean and go grab them over there. That's not what you do. You don't get them half ripe. But if you get a tomato at Gather, you get a tomato at Gather.
Right. So the menu is going to be fabulous. I think it'll be a great change. People will enjoy. Our menu stays kind of small, and we've got a couple of fun things coming in that we're doing. We'll have a soup of the day and a chili of the day every day now.
I saw your chili the other day for Pete's.
And we'll have chili every day, but we'll also have a soup of the day as well. So, you know, you've got some of those changes that as it gets cold, we all just kind of want to curl up with a little bowl of soup. And, our big bowl of soup. We've got some of those changes coming also. We have a fairly small menu. We've decreased it even a little bit more so that we're able to offer more of like a daily special, so that we can offer some different variety of change in items. If we get a good, you know, if we find out that, you know, Newsom's has a great ham coming that's a kind of a seasonal thing, we can pull that into our menu for the day and, you know, something like that, so that we have more flexibility in menu.
Okay, and these new milkshakes.
Yeah, the milkshakes are fantastic. We make all of our
ice cream. Have you seen them?
We make all of our ice cream base in-house, so they're all made with our own ice cream base. They're pretty fantastic. And
they're huge.
The big version, which everybody loves. We also have a small version in case you just decide you don't want to tackle a huge version by yourself.
Oh, yeah. I don't want to tackle. What?
Yeah, I do. They're enormous. I mean, if you want like 3 people to tackle one, the big one's good. But if you want a small one, we have that option also.
Well, those just look so good. And the fact that 25% of the proceeds out of all of that, you can not only feel good about what you're eating because it's good anyway, but then you can feel good about what you're eating. It's like guilt-free.
And we've had some people ask if they can't attend Saturday night, they can call or come by and leave a donation for Miss King. They can call and come by and buy a gift card, leave it for her family because they eat there, or buy it for themselves. Either way, the sales are still on that time frame, so the time that still goes towards Miss King.
Well, I thought it was cool that you guys were doing 25% because that's a large portion. I'm not going to say it's not. That's a really generous amount as far as, you know, out of the proceeds. But then, and I can see Craig, well, wait a minute. I want to do it too. So Taco John's is going to match that.
They are. So it ends up, if you do the math on that, then that's 50% of proceeds are going to go to Miss King because Whatever we sell at Gather on Main that night, the 25% proceeds will be matched by Taco John's of Princeton so that she will get 50% of proceeds for sales that night. So
amazing.
We expect next Saturday night to be busy. So tell your friends, come by, come see us for dinner. If you haven't been yet, it's a great time to come see what we have to offer because it is a little different for this area, and it's fun. And
oh, I'm
we
gonna
enjoy
tell you,
it.
Creme brulee.
The food is fantastic.
Is that still there?
Creme brulee is there. I just talked to my girl that's helping me in the bakery, and I think we're going to feature a nice, fun cake as dessert that night, too, that kind of goes with the Elizabeth King feel. So we'll have that as well. So it's going to be a nice, big event.
I saw pineapple margaritas.
Yeah, and the spicy pineapple margaritas.
Oh, hello.
I'm a spicy girl.
I'm not going to lie. We both love Suzanne. Good morning, Suzanne. She's our hair lady. And I'll tell you, I was sitting there, and when we were talking about the color of purple, I was like, you know that color of purple that margarita down
the the color of purple the margarita tastes? Yeah.
I want that. But that, you know, that's like my favorite margarita. Love it. And now you're doing a pineapple.
Yeah, we do. We do occasionally do special flavors, just kind of off cuff because it's fun and we do different things. And we had done a spicy pineapple margarita because one of your own requested a jalapeno margarita. So we went ahead and threw that on the menu a couple weeks ago. And a bunch of people said, good. We love it, but we don't want spicy. Can we have pineapple too?
Yeah.
So we did kind of a spicy versus not spicy at last night's
again,
happy hour.
That kind of sounds good for like a fall pineapple.
It was fun.
Yeah.
And we have that's that interesting little thing. We're a little bit different than a lot of places. We have our breakfast and lunch menu daily on the days that we're open. We're closed Sunday and Monday, but we are open for breakfast and lunch from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. and then we close our kitchen. On Thursdays, we reopen for a happy hour menu only. And I think there was some confusion. There has been some confusion about that. It's not a full menu, but it's got a lot of great things on
Gator
it.
Gator Bites.
Gator Bites, yeah. We have a burger special, a taco special, a salad. With the fall menu change, we have a charcuterie board that'll be on there as well.
Mm.
So there's a lot to
eat. Is
that
the one with the olives?
It's basically an adult Lunchable.
So good.
It's an adult Lunchable.
So good.
But, you know, we have a happy hour menu on Thursday nights. Friday and Saturday nights are our only nights for a full dinner menu. And that opens at 5 o'clock because we do a full menu change between lunch and dinner. So we do close kitchen from 2 to 5 to do that menu change.
Well, it's worth it. I'm just telling
fantastic.
You.
Fantastic.
Let her change it over. Give her a minute. Because, well, when you do that, I mean, that's you're really changing everything. I mean,
yeah.
You got to change over.
We have to
everything.
Change our entire cold station, our entire hot station in the kitchen. We have to change everything over. We have to prep menu items for dinner. We have to change out staff and give them a break. Still need staff. We need experienced kitchen staff still, so put in your resumes.
And by the way, wild game night.
Wild game night's coming.
Hello.
Up. Well, and next week is the last week that we have tickets for sale, and we are almost sold out of tickets. So if they want wild game night, they need to call now and reserve their tickets. So we will have something totally different for this area, which is a 5-course tasting menu. When you sign up for the wild game night, and it is featuring wild game, when you sign up to come and join us for that, we have Chef Josh Cook, but he's also bringing in another chef from Nashville. And they are doing a 5-course tasting menu.
Oh, wow.
So it'll be, I mean, you'll be full by the time you're done, but it comes out as 5 courses. Everybody's is set in stone. It's a certain menu. You come in and you get that 5 courses, but it will be unique and different and really showcase what we are at Gather on Main. It's going to be just slightly different than you've experienced before.
Okay,
and
well, you already do Gator Bites, so now my brain is going about 100 miles an hour.
And we have released menu. The menu is on the Facebook page for the Wild Game Night Dinner. We'll feature things like wild boar and venison. It's going to be fun.
You had me in wild boar.
And
right
then
there.
We've got Barrel and Bond fish is coming in from Barrel and Bond to do a bourbon pairing with it. If you want to do a bourbon pairing, so it'll be a 5 1-ounce pours of bourbon. It's a fantastic bourbon pairing. Of course, he's like the god of bourbon around here, so he can tell us anything and everything we need to know. And he's specifically pairing to match each menu item.
Wow.
So it's going to be a fun night. It's going to be fantastic.
That's an experience. That's one of those nights that it's an experience. You know, it's not anything that, you know, you're going to find every day everywhere.
No, and we have people coming in. It's kind of crazy how far away some people are coming in for the wild game night, and some because they know the chefs, and some just because they saw it on Facebook and thought, there's nothing like that around here, so they're going to drive in for it.
Well, you know what? A lot of us, we didn't get to go anywhere for fall break. We didn't get to do a lot of the things during the summer that we normally do. And this is something that we can do at home and not really have to go anywhere.
Right.
And that is so different. You might as well be, you know, all the way at the Keys somewhere for, you know, some exotic restaurant.
Right. And so that Wild Game Night dinner is the 24th. So it's the Saturday after the Elizabeth King dinner. So we will have Elizabeth's dinner next Saturday, and then the following Saturday we will be closed to public dining because it is a reservation only event.
Okay.
So, but it's if you're considering it, you need to consider it quickly because we are getting ready to close down ticket sales for that. Okay. We do have to have a head count in order to get our stuff in time. So, and
Wild
we're getting
boar.
You know, we've got to do things in a COVID safe manner. So we've got a limited number of seats we're selling for that and things also. So
you're having fun, evidently, is what it sounds like.
We are. And we've got, you know, this is the time of year that I like the best because we move into that season of caring where people want to give back and want to do things for the community. And this year, I think more than any, we need it. We need it so bad. I know I wanted to make sure while I was on here this morning, because we do the free kids meals on Halloween every year at Taco John's. We can't do interior dining this year. We haven't opened up our dining room because of technicalities with Taco John's corporate and the requirements that are needed to open it. But this is not the year to take that away from the kids. It's absolutely not. So we are working hard to make sure that we can safely still do free kids meals on Halloween. So that will still happen this year at Taco John's. People need to be patient with us. We will have to line up outside and let people in a few at a time. All meals will be to go. We will allow meals through drive-through this year because I think, you know, we're going to have such big lines going outside. Right. So we'll allow them to drive through this year. As with any other year, no purchase necessary. Any kid that's there gets a free kids meal. The kid has to be present. So you can't come in and say, I've got five kids and get five kids meals. You're going to have to have the kid present. We're going to ask everybody to wear your mask or costumes for safety reasons. We are only going to allow, I think, we've got two sets of registers. So we're going to allow everybody is going to come in one door and everybody's going to exit a different door. And we will only allow two families in at a time so that we can maintain proper spacing and all that good stuff. But these kids
can
still get their free meals.
You've got the sweetest lady at the window. I swear you do.
Crystal's great.
She is amazing. It's worth going there just to talk to her. I mean, because she'll open that window and she's got the biggest smile on her face. And that's worth all of it right there. But I think the kids being able to do that, that's just like we were talking about, you know, with Presley, is it's a sense of normal. It's a sense of,
yes,
we're still going to do this.
And I love that Fredonia has come up with a way to still have a safe trick-or-treat. And I think that Princeton really needs to step up now and decide what we're doing, because I don't think it's been decided yet. Not that I've seen. And, of course, we're in that new caveat of we've got a brand-new business downtown, and we had planned costumes. We were so looking forward to the downtown trick-or-treat, and I'm not 100% sure they're going to do it this year now. I think they could. I think they could make a line outside and have people spaced 6 feet apart and walk through. There was a line last year to get through it anyway. Mm-hmm. So I think it could be done. I just don't know what the decision on that will be.
Yeah.
That being said, we have brunch on Saturday mornings. Halloween happens to fall on a Saturday this year.
Woo!
So everybody needs to look, pay attention to the Facebook page, because we will be announcing a kids-friendly, fun holiday Halloween brunch for the kids so that they can come in and have a good start to their Halloween day. So we've got that coming up also. And then, you know, we follow that very, very shortly with Thanksgiving. Cray and I, when we decided to put in Gather on Main, and I'm talking before we even picked the bathroom sinks, which you know how important that was to me.
I love that.
We had decided way back then that we were going to do a free Thanksgiving meal on Thanksgiving for anybody in Princeton that needs it. We are moving forward at that this year. Mm-hmm. So we're going to be very, very quickly here asking for community help, asking for churches and banks and everybody else that wants to be involved to help start donating for the Thanksgiving meal. And we will offer on Thanksgiving Day a free meal to anybody who needs it at Gather. I know a lot of my crew is volunteering the day to come in and work, and we'll take volunteers from outside as well to make sure we get this done. But again, this is not the year to decide not to do that.
And what day is that now?
It'll be on Thanksgiving Day. So we will do our Thanksgiving on Friday.
I'll help you.
Yeah, we'll do it Thanksgiving Day, and we'll get people in there, and we'll make sure that anybody, you know, whether they can't afford Thanksgiving meal, whether they're just elderly and have no one to eat with and want a sense of community, whatever it might be, they can just come in and enjoy a good meal on Thanksgiving.
I love that.
So we're going to pair with a bunch of other, I'm sure that we're going to pair with a bunch of other places to help get this done. But this is not the time to say we're not doing it. So this has been a rough year for a lot of people. And we're going to try to finish this year with a big bang and do it the right way. And we've got fun events coming up. We've got a whole, we were working on calendar Monday on a whole season of caring. We're going to stack it. We start, you know, we've got, of course, Elizabeth King's is kind of a different thing, but it starts from that day forward. We've got about five other.
Gas pedal.
Yeah, we've got about five other events we're going to do. The Thanksgiving, Halloween for the kids, brunch morning, and moving forward from there. We've got a Santa's cookie event we're going to be scheduling and doing, proceeds of which will go to Hope and Cope to help some of these kids get some Christmas. So we're moving forward with all that. We're looking forward to what all we can do this season.
I'll tell you, about this time last year, we were talking about you on Food Network. And you know, you'd come in and say, oh, what did you do this week? I'm going to get so excited. And you could see your eyes twinkle. And I really have felt it for you this year because I know you were so excited and you guys were so to the moon excited to get it open. And I know this has been a rough year, but man, I respect the heck out of you.
It's been rough for a lot of people.
You've
been rough for a ton of people. And I don't even know. I mean, it's just been a bad year for a lot of people. And we've done everything we can to keep our staff and keep ourselves in a good mental place. And it's been tough. And I said, I think that's why I'm looking forward to this season so much. I threatened to put up Christmas trees 3 weeks ago.
Do it!
I threatened Cray and told him he was going to drag out all 45 Christmas trees 3 weeks ago because I was done with the year and ready to move on to Christmas.
Yeah, yeah.
But I think that as we move forward, things are starting to pick up. Things are starting to look better. And I think everybody's ready to move forward with a fun holiday season. And we're going to do our absolute best to make sure we do that. But we do that and at the same time give back to everybody who's helped us get through this year.
Well, it's in the name. Gather.
Absolutely.
And the rest of it's just directions, basically. Gather on Main. So we've got the 17th.
The 17th.
I want to make sure that everybody
for
knows
Ms.
about
King.
Dinner,
and that's the
dinner
one.
For King.
Go on, find a post. They're on her page. They're on our page. They're on all the teachers'
my
pages.
Page.
Share that post. Grab it. Share it. Remind people. Come in. Eat dinner with us that night. Be patient if we are busy, because we probably right. will be busy. But we'll be all hands on deck at our restaurant that night to make sure we get people seated and fed in a timely manner. And all of that is so that Elizabeth King can wrap up her treatments here and get back to her normal life.
You know what? She can rest a little easier, take a brick or two off the shoulder, because
yeah.
she's pretty full right now. Got on the 24th, Wild Game.
Wild Game dinner, yep.
And 31st, we've got, well, that is every Saturday.
It's, yeah,
what
it's
were you
kind
thinking?
Of crazy.
I bet Cray is like, I'm going on vacation. I don't know what she's doing. The 31st, we've got Taco John's. Free kids meals.
Free kids meals on the 31st at Taco John's. And then we will also have a Gather on Main brunch event for the kids at Halloween. We follow that a couple weeks later, we hope, with a chili cook-off as a fundraiser for the Thanksgiving dinner.
Yes.
So,
and then Thanksgiving is right around the corner. Yeah. We're going to feed the people that need it.
Right.
I love you.
And then we're going to move
telling
forward
you.
From there for Christmas.
Tell Cray that we love him, too. And you guys, we appreciate everything you do.
He's working hard. I give him all kinds of grief. I am not an easy person to live with. I give that poor man all kinds of grief, but he does everything he can to do whatever he's got to do to make sure that I can live out my dream.
I pick at him a lot, but I'm going to tell you what, he is a really good human being, just period. I mean, that's, you know, end quote. That is, and we appreciate both of you. She brought me coffee this morning. I love the woman, I'm telling you. It's even got a little heart on the top of it. I love her to death, and Cray and everybody. Thanks for all that you do for all of them.
Well, thank you for having us on. We're doing the scavenger hunt with you all, too. We'll be part of that as well. So I know that's coming up also.
We're going to have a lot of fun. I think that's the for the season, for the holiday season this year, it's going to be fun.
Yeah.
Something different, lighthearted, and fun, I think is much needed.
I do, too. I absolutely do, too.
I'm telling you what, from Food Network to tearing it up locally in Princeton, we appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, kid.
Thank you.
Hey, have a great weekend. Have a safe weekend and be kind to one another. Find something good to do.
Your home team at Trice Hughes wants to make sure your vehicle lasts as long as possible, especially since warmer weather means more driving. Trice Hughes reminds you that tire pressure is critical to maximizing the performance of your vehicle. From improved fuel mileage to smoother tire wear, make sure your tires are inflated to the correct PSI.
Trice Hughes is here for you. and any questions you may have about your vehicle. Buy your next vehicle from the home team. Find them on Highway 91 North, Princeton, or at ChoiceHughes.com.
One of the greatest rights as citizens of the United States is the right to vote. And Farless Realty encourages you to get out and vote on November 3rd. If you do not feel safe going to the polls on Election Day, contact your county clerk's office for early voting options. Your vote counts, so let your voice be heard.
Celebrating 70 years of community service, we're 1580, 103.3 WPKY Princeton.
I'm Chris Foster. President Trump, expecting to be cleared by the White House doctor, wants to get back out campaigning in person.
After the White House physician released a memo saying the president could return to public engagements on Saturday, President Trump said on Hannity,